G'day guys, welcome to Peeex Fishing. You're with Craig Connolly and I want to start the video this week by showing you my new custom soft bait rod that was built by Kevin at K-Labs. So I go through the review, it actually features in today's video towards the later part of the video. Beautiful rod, so let's go and take a look at it. This is a CTS blank. Now CTS is a New Zealand company based in Birkenhead. They make the blanks. And the blank, this is a full one-piece rod. There's no splits in it at all. It's one piece the whole way through. It's 4 to 6 kilo rated, 7 foot long, and it's called a CTS Air Turbo, and it is a absolute stunner. I've gone for a very minimalistic look through here. Don't like a lot of the EVA, I'm not a fan of it. Got some lovely EVA there though, just to hold on to, bit of bling. Beautiful Alps reel seat there, matched up to a more than 2500 Daiwa reel, which has got the Verivas braid on it, and it's Shoremaster Avani, and it's a casting braid, white as you can see. And then the guides are the Alp titanium with zirconium inserts, so very, very light, beautifully suited for this rod. So I did christen the rod on a nice snapper towards midday. Wasn't sort of, the fish just weren't firing first thing in the morning for us anyway, or for me. If you're interested in custom rods, if you want to talk to someone who really knows rods like the back of his hand, Kevin at K-Labs is your man. He's a great guy, very knowledgeable, very friendly, very helpful. And if you don't know what you want, he'll help you sort of, get into the and design your own and get something that you really, really want. So this thing is just perfect for what I do. I could not wish for a better rod. So check him out. Kevin at K-Labs makes beautiful, beautiful rods. Good morning. Welcome to Peeex Fishing. You're with Craig Connolly and it's a very foggy morning. You probably can't see much at all. It is a full moon. Pretty foggy start to the day. No wind at the moment, and the wind is forecast to be very, very light today, so the fog's probably going to hang around for quite a while until the breeze picks up, which is probably around 11 o'clock. So I'm meeting a couple of guys here today. We'll be fishing together, so probably the plan of attack is to just fish the shallows around the back of Waiheke while the fog's hanging around, then potentially head out to the Noisies, or we might even head over towards the Firth. So unsure yet, but there will be definitely shallow water stuff to start the day off with. There's the old ferry coming up the channel there. So we just travelled down the length of Waiheke, and you can't really see, it's very foggy down this end, but we are sort of in 35 metres. That's the edge of Waiheke here. That's Das and his brother there, and he just caught a beautiful 47 centimetre snapper just on a 60 gram jig. We've got a little bit of sign here, and over here somewhere is Gannet Rock. You can't see it because of the fog, and it's bloody cold. There's the gannets coming back. Soft bait ready to go, or I want to give this one a go. This is a Abyss 100 gram, and I've got a little bit of fluoro on there I've added. It's a pretty good sign right under us, so I'll give that a go right on top of it. We'll get this one out of the way. Put them over there. Yep, straight in. So I'm on the Salty Shape Tailwalk rod, Japanese one designed for this purpose, working lures. And you can see it's 34 meters. I don't know if you can see all the sign there. So we're just off Hooks Bay. And Das is over there. But this will be a keeping fish. And just lovely on this light gear. This is a little Trinidad 10A that I had refurbished by Swordfish Steve. Bought it off a fellow jet skier. And it's just, oh, I absolutely love this reel. It's just so silky smooth. The Trinidad 10A, I don't think they make them anymore. That's a nice snapper. Nice snapper. On the abyss. There he is. He's probably 44 or something like that. Good fish. Right, we'll dispatch him and get this one down again. Looks like they're on the chew. It's a murky old day out here. It's actually bloody cold now. We were beautifully warm before before we moved down here, because the fog is still here and it's actually really chilly. Put that there. Mix it up a bit today. So the next one I've got is this one here. Now it's pretty heavy, but it doesn't matter because we've got quite a lot of current here and it's full moon, so the tide is really belting through and it's only just started to run. So this one is a combination of a jig that you jig up and down, like, and it's got the backing on there, so you know it flutters as it goes down, combined with quite a chunky skirt there, which is Lumo. So I normally use this one when we go out towards flat rock in about 55 meters, because the drift is so strong here and there's a lot of good fish sign. There's some pretty good sized fish here. The Craig, if you were watching, this is probably close to where you were yesterday. I think Craig got a couple of 6-pounders. So, you know, for wintertime fishing, good eating fish. Oh my god. I've got a thing about pumpkins. Every time I go near a bloody pumpkin, I cut my hands. And did the same last night. And it's very hard to tie jigs, put soft baits on, etc. So that's what you end up with. You end up with that lure that looks like that, and it runs up and down there freely, up and down like that, and you can jig it the same as you normally would, like I was just doing with the abyss. It can flutter down as it goes down, and you've got to, that's your hook there. So I think we'll run back to the spot and give that one a go. It's a bit overkill, 160 grams, but at least it will stay on the bottom for a while. Yeah, it's a pretty quick drift here, and the wind has dropped off, the fog's just about gone, which is brilliant. Sun's coming out because it was bloody cold before, very cold. Okay, the sign's directly underneath us now, so in theory they should be fighting over this. Right, so what I'll do is bring it right up to the top and drop it right down again. See if we can, oh, there's a fish. Oh damn, lost it. Bugger. That must have been a car wire or something. It was on for a brief second. Yep. Oh, yeah. Whatever it was, it chewed the skirt a bit. It's okay. Right, let's go again.
Yeah.
Oh, this feels like a pretty good fish. Yeah. The old rock hopper. These were being discounted all over the place for 10 bucks each, and I tell you what, they are a bloody good lure. I already like them, particularly in deeper water like 55 meters, because you get down really quick and you got three things working for you. You got the flutter on the way down so people, the fish see it, which is this fish clearly did, because that one hit it as soon as it got to the bottom, and you can work it like you do with a slow pitch, and then you got a kabura on it as well. Good fun, and this feels like a pretty chunky fish. It's probably bigger than the last one, I think. Yeah, that's a beauty. That's a beauty. Beautiful. Oh, these are beautiful eating fish, these. Good winter, fat, healthy snapper. So that's about the same size as the other one, I think, probably about 44 or something. So we will get him dispatched, and I'll just get a quick measure on him if I can get him laid out. Is, yeah, I'd say 40, 42, maybe 42, 43. Good eating. Right, get him in the bin. Well, there's the A-team. The only men I know who have got bloody bare feet in winter. So it weighs 48 grams, this rod, and I've matched it up to a Daiwa more than 2500. And I tell you what, it feels beautiful. So what I need to do is christen it with a decent fish, and this is going to be the spot. So I've got my the same weedless rig on I had last week, which is just the old gulp there, and I've got a little ball protector on there just to protect the knot this time. So we'll see how we go. Alright, so we've got the first decent fish on the new soft bait rod. And this was on a... Yeah, it's just a nice snapper, I think. This was on a gulp, crazy legs, new penny. My absolute favourite winter bait. And I'll tell you what, this rod is beautiful. Very happy with it, Kev. It's a nice one. That's a beautiful, beautiful eating fish. Oh, lovely. Lovely. Now the lads over here have bloody smoked me today, the buggers. Look at them. Bloody smiling, carrying on. They've got about 9 fish in there. Hoo yeah. Got Trevally and Snapper and...
I'll